A second flight will land in Sydney this evening as part of the government's mission to bring Australians home from the conflict. The first plane load of passengers touched down last night with emotional reunions at the airport.
Fluffy unicorn in hand, Alan Landis can hardly wait a second longer to greet his 14-month-old granddaughter.
It's got to be colourful. It really attracts some.
At 2 a.m, they got the call that their son Michael and daughter-in-law Limor would be on the first repatriation flight carrying Australians fleeing Israel.
There's so much family over there that they're in such a difficult situation. Yeah. It's so hard.
After an anxious wait for families...
Yeah, I have butterflies in my stomach right now.
Passengers touched down on Qatar flight 7424 from Dubai. Straight into the arms of brothers...
Pretty bad to get a haircut.
..and the tight squeeze of mum.
They are so grateful to the Australian government, who they praise to the hilt.
So we're very happy here. Thank you so much. Thank you.
The government also helping bring home our Pacific neighbours. Almost 700 passengers have now left Tel Aviv on government-assisted flights.
You see, my face is not so stressed.
She hasn't slept in 3 days.
The immense relief for those arriving back on home shores is coupled with pain and worry as many leave family members behind.
My heart's with my people in Israel. It's heartbreaking what we've been through for the last 2 weeks. Life is not going to be the same.
We've had friends that their kids are being sent to the army. My daughter's friends already been killed. It's too much.
The Department of Foreign Affairs remains in contact with 1,200 Australians caught in the crisis.
We found the detail of 45 Australians who are still in Gaza. Every Australian matters.
But not all want to leave.
Mum and Dad are just not ready to get on the flight, to leave Israel yet. They're very quite patriotic.
A Qantas A380 is also on its way to Sydney tonight.
Thank you, Australia.
Some happiness amid the heartbreak. Sarah Navin for 10 News First.